For the newest media frontier, the sky is the limit. Matt Waite says he was watching a demonstration of an unmanned aircraft photographing the landscape to make a map when he had an epiphany.
It just absolutely blew my mind. I watched this and I thought, there is every tornado that I've ever covered as a journalist. There's every hurricane, flood, wildfire, you know, biblical disaster of you know, use your imagination.
Drones have long served as the eyes and arms of the U.S. military and intelligence agencies, but Waite believes the capabilities of $1,500 drones like this could be just as useful to news organizations.
And he walks in my office and says, I want to create a drone journalism lab. And my first thought was, what is that?
With a $50,000 grant from the Knight Foundation, the University of Nebraska launched the world's first UAV lab for young journalists.
We are quite literally creating this new tool for journalists to use, because there are no guidelines, there are no suggestions on how you should use this, what you can use it for. We're just making everything up, and I want to keep doing that.
The picture on this test model might look a little wobbly, but with refinements, it can look like this. And eventually, drone journalism could mean almost no place is out of reach. There's still a work in progress.
Oh!
But a drone is already in use in Australia to cover cricket. Could airborne paparazzi and unmanned car chase coverage be next? The technology is so far ahead of the law, it has left many questions unanswered.
Somebody says, well, if that thing flies over my house, I'm getting my shotgun out and I'm going to shoot it down. It's actually, as silly as it sounds, it's actually not clear whether or not they could do that. And you know, when we think about it, we are kind of writing the rule book.
For now, commercial drones are still illegal in the U.S., but aviation authorities are crafting new laws that could have drones like this filling the skies by 2015. John Hendren, Al Jazeera, Lincoln, Nebraska.